I'm Tracy Ellis, and this is The Elephant in the Dome, the official podcast of the Washington State Senate Republican Caucus. A court says Latino representation in the 15th legislative district, which is in eastern Washington, is insufficient to satisfy the Federal Voting Rights Act. While Senate Republican leader John Braun disagrees with that decision, he says the legislature needs to call itself into session and reconvene the State Redistricting Commission to redraw the map. If the commission doesn't draw the new map, the court will determine the boundaries. Senator Braun joins me now. First off, I was kind of hoping you could explain how we got here and what actually is going on.
Yeah, so that's a long story or a long process, but you know, in simple terms, you know, every 10 years we have a redistricting process in conjunction with the U.S. Census. We did our redistricting, and by the way, by most people's estimation, Washington State has the best program or the model program for redistricting in the country. We have a bipartisan process put into the Constitution by a vote of the people that involves, you know, two Republicans and two Democrats that have to get, you know, have to come to an agreement that they all support. And they did that. And then it wasn't as smooth as many of us would have liked, but they did that. The state Supreme Court affirmed that they did their job properly back in 2022. And the legislature, I'm sorry, 2021, and the legislature approved those maps in 2022. So we were on a good track, and then we had a lawsuit by a very Democratic affiliated organization out of California, based at UCLA, filed a suit against those redistricting maps, saying that they weren't done properly. We have a counter lawsuit saying that they weren't done properly, but in the different direction, not consistent with the 14th Amendment of the U.S. Constitution. That has played out over the last year and a half. And the bottom line is the court has ruled that there is some evidence of what they call cracking, which means there's a homogeneous Latino population in eastern Washington, and they're split between more than one district. I don't think that's true. They're collecting populations in Pasco and Toppenish and Sunnyside and Yakima that are very, you know, distinct and divided by large geographical space, and saying it's homogenous. I disagree with that, but the bottom line is the court has said we need to redo it. They've been very complimentary of the commission, but said they didn't get it quite right. They need to redo it. Okay, I can disagree with that, but the right way to do it, if you're going to redo it, the right way, the transparent way, the inclusive way, the way that's open to the public, is to reconvene the redistricting commission to redraw those maps and get them compliant from the court's perspective with the Voting Rights Act, the Federal Voting Rights Act.
Why do you think reconvening the commission to redraw those maps is a better option than having the court just do it?
Well, let's just be clear. I mean, people say they want to take politics out of redistricting, but the bottom line, it's an inherently political process. You can't do that. And you see it done, you know, wildly badly around the country with either Democrats or Republicans controlling the process and getting very gerrymandered maps. In our state, we have a good process. It takes a balance. Everybody has to agree. And that's led to better balance over time. Now we face a choice. Either we do it ourselves, and I don't want to be clear on this, constitutionally, redistricting is a legislative duty. The Redistricting Commission is a legislative agency. It is our responsibility to do this. And what the majority Democrats have said is they're comfortable turning it over to a judicial process, one that is not going to be inclusive, that won't be transparent, that won't involve the public, that has no requirements to adhere to public records meetings, none of this stuff. And they're going to do it that way versus, as I said earlier, reconvening the Redistricting Commission, having an open process, getting public comment, getting to the right decision through public meetings with citizens being able to voice their concerns on getting the maps drawn right. It's just a better process. It's the process the people put in place over three decades ago.
Why do you think majority Democrats are content with the court redrawing the map? I mean, why do you think that is?
I mean, candidly, I just think they're not happy with the bipartisan process. They think they want more, and they have and this has been well reported. They have tried to game the redistricting process to move it to the courts, where they think they'll get a better outcome. They think that they can sue and get something they can't get by negotiating in a bipartisan way.
We should let people know that these court cases that you mentioned earlier are ongoing, actually. They're being appealed, one to the Supreme Court, I believe, and the other to the Ninth Circuit Court of Appeals. Is that right?
That is correct. There are two cases, the Soto Palmer case, which was the one filed by the organization out of UCLA, entirely funded by Democratic funding sources and the state of California interfering in the state of Washington. That one is the one that's got the order to redraw the maps, and it's being appealed, or I think has been appealed, to the Ninth Circuit Court. And then the other one, the Garcia Hobbs case, which claims that the whole process violates the 14th Amendment of the U.S. Constitution. That one's a little different, and it is appealed directly to the U.S. Supreme Court. And that hasn't been appealed yet, but I expect it to be very shortly.
Now, we're talking about the 15th legislative district in eastern Washington. It's kind of, I would say, central Washington rather than south central. Is that a good way of explaining it? It includes the Tri-Cities, yes. Includes Yakima. Since this is a Senate podcast, we'll just talk about the current senator is Nikki Torres. Now, is there a chance that this could somehow impact her? She's the one who's representing the district now.
Absolutely. And this is my top concern. Here we have a Latina state senator, ran for office last year in 2022, won with 67% of the vote, did a fabulous job during her first session this year, really is a rock star. And she's now at risk of being redistricted out of the 15th district. It's just wrong. Here we are trying to protect the interests of the Hispanic community, and we're trying, and the very process could result in moving out, redistricting out a sitting state senator who won with 67% of the vote. That's just wrong on its face. That wouldn't happen. I virtually guarantee that wouldn't happen if we reconvene the redistricting commission. But I have deep concerns that the judicial process could result in exactly that, and not only be a huge political win for the Democrats, but be a real disservice to the voters of the 15th district to put Nikki Torres in office.
Nikki Torres, as you mentioned, is Latina. Her parents were actually farm workers, and she worked herself through college and doing different jobs and, master's degree, and became a state senator. Does it seem to you that the Democrats, it almost seems like it's not about having Hispanic representation. It almost seems like it's about having Democrat representation for this area. Do you feel like that's kind of what's happening here? Because you have a Latina, as we have mentioned here, representing the district right now. I'm not sure how does this, I guess, explain the thinking here?
I am candidly at a loss. I think it absolutely is about having a Democrat district, not about having a true representation of Latino and Hispanic values from that district, because they have that right now. They have that in Nikki Torres, and they're putting that at risk. This is about having, not just someone who looks like that community, but someone who thinks like them, rather than truly representing the interests of the district. That's what's really wrong about this. It's just the wrong way to approach it. I mean, it's still stunning to me that the judges can look at this, see the fact that we have a person with a fabulous story, a fabulous background, who's worked her way through life to achieve many things, one of which is getting elected overwhelmingly as the state senator. It happens to be Latina, and our answer to that is to redraw the maps. That is still stunning to me that's the conclusion they can come to after looking at the facts. But that is where we're at. So if that's where we're at, we should do it right. We should do it by reconvening redistricting commission, do it in the public, do it with transparency, do it with inclusion of citizen voices in the district and around the district. Do it right.
Talking with Senate Republican leader John Braun, let's get back to that redistricting commission. There were some issues with the redistricting commission, if I remember right. There were some issues with transparency, not following the open public meetings laws, that sort of thing. But you're still saying that's a better option, and that those issues with the redistricting commission back in 2021 can be resolved and it can be done the right way this time.
That's right. You know, I've said this, and I still believe we have the model redistricting policy and procedure in the country. But there's no getting around. We didn't perform at our best during this last redistricting, especially towards the end. And there's a lot of reasons for that. You know, it was during the pandemic that, you know, but also the, you know, we didn't get the training and advice that should have happened on public records to the commission. We had one commissioner, and I don't want to get into too much detail there. It's been well reported, who was trying, you know, very clearly trying to undermine the process. Those are all true. And frankly, we fell short of what we expected from the commission on public meetings compliance. But that's all been well reported. There's a lot of attention making sure they get it right the next time. I still think we have a model process. I still think this is the right way. And I think we will all be watching closely that they do it right if we reconvene the commission. So I have no doubt if we have that opportunity, if the majority Democrats are willing, and I want to be very clear, that's the only thing standing in the way. The majority Democrats in both the House and the Senate have said, we are not willing to reconvene the commission. We want a judicial outcome. And that's just wrong. If they were willing to do that, I have no doubt, based on, you know, just public attention, media attention, that the redistricting commission would do a good job.
It's interesting. The judge who found that the district is violating the Federal Voting Rights Act, actually, and you mentioned this briefly, was complimentary of the commission and suggested that the commission be the ones who actually redraw this map, right? It's not like the judge was saying there was something inherently flawed with the commission process, right?
That's absolutely true. If you actually read the opinion, and if you had the time and you went back and listened to the comments during the hearing, the judge was very complimentary of the redistricting commission, of the bipartisan process, of the will, the need to have give and take as they negotiate districts that work for both sides and are balanced. And in his order, he suggested, and unfortunately, he didn't order. He just said, we may reconstitute the commission. And I want to be clear, that is allowed by our Constitution. It's allowed by what the people of the state of Washington put into place. He saw that as the best option, recommended that's what we do, and said, if you don't do that, he will step in and, you know, dictate what the new maps should look like. But even the judge, who ruled against what I think is the right answer, still got it right here and said, we should do this with the redistricting commission. And yet the majority of Democrats are saying, no, we'd rather the judicial process do this. It's just wrongheaded. And I want to be clear, you know, across the country, we have states fighting to keep federal courts from writing their districts. In Washington, we're backwards. We're saying, nope, we don't want to do what is truly our legislative duty. We want the courts to do it for us. It's backwards and it's wrong.
But this is a done deal at this point, right? I mean, the majority Democrats who run the legislature have said they aren't going to reconvene the commission. They aren't going to call a special session so lawmakers could even vote on doing that. And at this point, there's really nothing that can be done. The judge is going to be the one making the final call.
At this point, yeah, it looks like that. And I don't know what the judge will do. I mean, there's a chance. I don't know that it's a big chance. There's a chance the judge would say, nope, I said you may reconvene. Now I'm saying you must reconvene and put it back on the table. I'd like to think he'll do that. I'm not sure that he will. There's certainly the opportunity for the public to get involved and say, hey, knock it off, majority. This is the wrong thing to do. We meant it when we said we want our districts made in a bipartisan process through the commission, and maybe they would change their minds. I think right now what they're trying to do is rush the process. They're saying, no, we're not going to do that. Let's get to the end. Because what would happen is if we were in session, we would call for a vote. We would insist on a vote that says, okay, you say you're not going to reconvene. I want to see you vote for a process that is, you know, that is untransparent, that is not inclusive, over the existing or reconvening the redistricting commission that would be open, transparent, accessible, inclusive. I want to see them take that vote. What they're trying to do is get it their way without ever having to go on record that they're voting against open public access to the process.
Yeah, we should explain to people why that vote is important, because it holds elected officials accountable, right? I mean, that's the idea of, because it, I mean, Democrats will just vote against doing it, even if it did come up for, I mean, probably, I guess we shouldn't say for sure, but probably Democrats would just vote against reconvening the commission because that's not what they want. But it's about holding elected officials accountable.
Yeah, and I'm not sure how they'd vote. I think if actually put to the test, I'd be really curious how they vote. Would they really stand with, you know, stand behind a black box, non-transparent process, or would they vote what they say? They say they believe in transparency. They say they believe in public access. They say they believe in including citizens in the process. But that's not what they're doing. A vote would force them to go on record and say, and either vote what they say or vote what they're currently doing. And it's wrong that they're going the direction they're going. It's even more wrong that they're doing it sort of in secret without having individual legislators have to vote on the step forward.
That's Senate Republican Leader John Braun. This is The Elephant in the Dome, the official podcast of the Washington State Senate Republican Caucus. I'm Tracy Ellis.